Ryan Snelling here with Austin Burke. We just got out of the theater. We've had the privilege of seeing two back-to-back Indian bangers.
Bangers.
We just saw Kill, and my blood is pumping, I guess is the best way to put it. My blood is pumping. I'm excitable. Do you feel the way I feel right now?
100%. I actually didn't know how you felt walking out of that theater. I'm like, I'm trying to read him. I don't know. No, I was all in, on the edge of my seat. I had to use the bathroom for the last 30 minutes of the movie. I could not leave that seat because I was afraid I was going to miss something. I loved that movie.
Yeah. Did you not see me like cradling myself? I can't do it now because I'm holding a monopod, but I usually grab my hands and just like move my elbows around like this when I'm trying. Yeah, that happened a lot in this movie. So it was obviously gory and bloody. You get that from the trailer. I walked into this movie excited because to me, unlike Kalki, I thought this was going to be something more conventional, something that we were more used to. How do Indians do John Wick on a train? Mm-hmm. That's what I described it as. I didn't know that I wasn't going to get conventional.
Uh-huh.
This was unconventional and so un-American. Like, yeah, there were fight scenes and I've seen movies on a train, but other than that, it was actually pretty unique and surprising to me.
I mean, across the board, surprising decisions. They did things that I did not expect them to do involving characters. I had no clue that was going to happen. This was going to happen. I mean, it was so unconventional in there were decisions made here that I don't think we would get in a movie like this in America. I've seen examples. Yeah. And we don't get stuff like that, right? We've seen action sequences that were maybe a little bit more unique than what we saw in this. But in terms of the style that they were going for and the kills specifically, the amount of blood and gore and sound effects and sound design behind each kill, I thought was magnificent. And just the way it builds and then you get that title card, 35-40 minutes into the movie. And that's when I knew, I'm like, oh, we're sitting in something special here.
Yeah.
This is so different compared to what I expected. I was all in at that point.
Yeah, I equated it to John Wick just because it's about a guy who has to go through the seven layers of hell to get what he wants. John Wick is a revenge story. Mm-hmm. This movie, most of the time, isn't about revenge. No. It becomes about revenge eventually, and that's all I'm going to say about that. The title card of the movie happens an hour in. I don't think I've ever seen that before. It's an hour in. Like, The Departed has one, like, 20 minutes in.
Yeah.
This is an hour in. I guess another way to describe this type of movie is, you know, it's one step forward, two steps back for our hero until he ultimately conquers. He battles a bunch of nameless, faceless villains, and then there's a head at the end of the table, right? That's the kind of stuff. It's not as simple as that with this. One step forward, two steps back. You also saw that with the villains.
Yeah.
The villains had their own scenes where they dealt with their loved ones. We dealt with the villain's conscience. There's one scene in particular that was like a haunted house. And we watched our villains feel emotions.
Yeah.
Feel horror. I don't know that I can recall any scene like that.
And they did such a good job of building them up. I mean, obviously you want them to fail and you want them all to die, but those sequences where they are feeling those emotions, and specifically one conversation where they talk about the fact that, let's not do all of this BS and say that we mean all of these things. We are here to do something that is terrible. So don't even, and there's a moral conflict between the people on that side of the story, right? You want them to fail, but you at least understand that there is a bit of emotion, humanity inside of that. And that's so cool. In this setting, I've never really seen anything like that. And then to root against them and our hero, just the way that he takes them out, but also taking a beating along the way. He's not an impenetrable force like maybe some heroes in these types of movies would be, man.
Yeah.
He gets beat up and it is rough to see him continue.
Our hero...
Heroes.
He gets the shit beat out of him. Just the absolute piss out of him. They take out guns from the equation for the most part. That doesn't mean that guns aren't in the movie, but they take out guns. They resort to like hammers, blunt objects, knives. We see some epic
brutal
kills.
Brutal.
Brutal, epic kills without guns in this movie. And that's kind of what's nice. I mean, that's another thing about John Wick is, you know, some of these scenes, you're just watching John Wick plow through people with guns. He can deflect bullets with his jacket and then just mow through them. In this movie, it's not as simple as that. So this guy truly has to fight through hell to get to where he's going. And I guess another movie I was thinking about was Snowpiercer. Snowpiercer is sequenced beautifully because every car introduces a different element. And this doesn't have like an A to B direction, if you will. Sure. Like they actually use the train in a different way, whereas different people can be in different parts of the train at different times for various reasons. And so that was kind of cool. So it wasn't quite like Snowpiercer either. So every time I tried to nail this down and pin this down, I failed. I was wrong. American movies, we've seen so many of them. You can kind of feel what type of scene you're in.
Yes.
You know, you can feel like, oh, the bad guy's not going to die here because he has to die later. And you can tell, like, this is where the hero's going to come out from nowhere. And do, like, we can figure that kind of stuff out. This movie never lets that happen because there are some things that are super consequential. And they happen just so quick. Mm-hmm. And they happen a lot sooner than they would in an American movie. Or they never happen at all. I mean, we were just constantly trying to figure out what this movie was.
Yeah, you can't nail it down, right? Is it John Wick? Is it Bullet Train? Is it... it's a little bit of that, but really none of that at the end of the day. Because it really is its own unique thing and unique spin. And, you know, I was questioning it about 10 minutes in because we had some romantic sequences where they use music to emotionally manipulate you. And one scene in particular that you and I were kind of laughing at, the ring, it was really weird, but I understand now why they did those types of things. It's to set the stage for something that you're not expecting.
Yeah.
And what I didn't expect is how brutal it would get. And right before that title card hit, but especially when that title card hit, that's when I realized, oh my God, I'm actually gripping my seat. I physically, I don't know if you saw me at one point in the movie, I had my hand behind my head and I'm sitting here like this, and I didn't realize I was doing it because I was so just engaged with what was happening, man. And I mentioned how sometimes the music wouldn't work all the way, but when he is just on this rampage, that music that was happening, the chanting behind him when he was coming through that train, man. Oh my God. Like one of my favorite heroic characters of the year so far. Just so much fun to watch. And even those moments that were more conventional, there was still some things about them that I found that they were separating themselves from other movies like this. And so, yeah, man, it got better as it went. And as it continued into that third act, I'm like, this is one of the most epic movies of the year. And it's such a simple premise, which is brilliant. And that's I love that.
We can't shut this off without mentioning the character's name, which was Amrit.
Yes.
Just an incredible character, for sure. I would love to see another movie with him. It doesn't need a sequel.
No,
I would just definitely watch it, for sure. You know, it's funny. The one movie that we should have obviously mentioned that we didn't was Monkey Man.
For sure,
Which I'm going to leave it at that.
Yeah.
Watching this made me forget about Monkey Man.
Yeah, I'm with you.
We are going to pod more about this on Movie Mode. So guys, subscribe to Movie Mode, follow Movie Mode wherever you listen to podcasts. You can find the Movie Mode YouTube channel as well. We're going to have a more in-depth discussion there. We'll see you then. Bye-bye. And go see Kill.
Please.